zoom in on my shingles. In the past year, I've had pneumonia, shingles, and valley fever. So the rule here is flipping houses will fucking kill you. Tri-Plex that I just picked up at 1514 West Sherman Street. It's actually metered. It has two electrical meters and it's zoned for multifamily. So it's got two buildings. It's zoned for up to three units. So we're going to split the single family house up front into a duplex. And then we're going to run this guest house as a triplex. But you got to be careful when you're working with these shiesty wholesalers because they're going to try to stick you with a property that's single family that's been chopped up and is advertised as an apartment complex, but it's zoned for single family. If you go to the city to try to get a permit, then they're gonna say that you have illegal units on there and they're not gonna work with you unless you make it back into a single family house. So check the zoning first, like this one.
All right, raise your hand if January 2019 kicked you in the baby maker like it did me. Good night. While my personal life and health are falling apart, business is good, so we just picked up a triplex. Let's take a deep dive into the numbers on this because while all hell is breaking loose, I like to focus on my business. We purchased this property for $99,000 through a wholesaler that was marketing it as a single family house with a guest house. Our loan amount is for $140,000 through a private money lender that charges us 12% a year. That means our payments are going to be $1,400 a month. After we get these units renovated, they're going to rent out for $750 a month, which comes out to $2,250 if we get 100% occupancy. So we're cash flowing, even if we get this crazy high interest rate. After we replace our hard money loan with a conventional loan, it's going to look like probably $1,000 a month, maybe $1,100 a month on our loan amount for that original $140,000. We're just replacing that with a lower interest rate, probably around 6%. So at $2,250, we're going to be taking home $1,200 a month. After this is finished, then we just rinse and repeat. We can do it 9 more times. We're looking to add 30 to 40 units with this plan over the next 18 months. Now let's look at option 2. We bought this property. It's worth $75,000 a unit on a resale market. So we're walking in straight up with $85,000 in equity after it's been renovated. Based on the recent turn of events in my life, let's say my luck has run out at 37. I get hit by a bus tomorrow. Option 3, my little brother Cruz down at Big Brother's Big Sisters inherits these things and it pays for his college fund. That's not a bad option either. Just for a quick review, option 1, you want to keep these things. You want to keep multifamily investments forever. They are ATM machines. You're making money each month, get the tenants to pay down your principal reduction, and they appreciate. It's going to go up in value potentially. Option 2, you cash out quick. We're going to flip it. We've done that several times and made huge margins on other properties, as you'll see in later videos. Or option 3, I get stricken with some sort of bubonic plague based on how my luck has run out. And I'm going to do this at my funeral. I'm just going to have like a roulette wheel and it's going to have different properties on it. And you're all going to be surprised when you inherit something from me. It's going to be some sort of elaborate lottery system set to maybe some David Bowie in the background where everybody wins a prize. But anyway, that's it for now. I hope you guys enjoy these videos, but we have so much stuff coming up. We have invested in a lot of properties recently. Keep sticking with us. Hope you learned something. I hope it inspires you to do something in the real estate investment market as well. And I'll holler at y'all later.
Oh my God. I thought that was a 10.